I'm just going to say this. Any media person that I see in person for the rest of my life who try to tell me LeBron James is good as Michael Jordan, I'm just going to slap the hell out of him right on the spot. Right? No question asked. The next person who walks up to me and say, LeBron James, who is amazing, as good as Michael Jordan or competes like Michael Jordan, I'm just going to slap the hell out of you right on the spot. And I'm going to take my chances with the judicial system.
Rodney Hood.
I've ever seen play basketball, he'd be one of them. I think he's the best athlete I've ever seen play basketball, bar none. If I were going to pick people with the best ability I'd ever seen play the game, he'd be one of them. If I were going to pick the best competitors that I'd ever seen play, he'd be one of them. So in the categories of competitiveness, ability, skill, and then athletic ability, he's the best athlete, he's one of the best competitors, he's one of the most skilled players. And that, to me, makes him the best basketball player that I've ever seen play.
Not Michael Jordan. You know, it's two different animal. Michael was a killer. He's an assassin. You know, LeBron is more of a facilitator. He's, you know, he's the guy that you're gonna give the ball, and he's thinking shoot first before pass. Where Michael, you give him the ball, he's thinking he's gonna score 50 on you, and then he's gonna pass. And Michael Jordan was the best player, the greatest player in my era. There's been a lot of great players in this league, and it's hard to, you know, to give one player that best ever crown, but all I can say is in my era, Michael Jordan was the best player in my era, and he's, I mean, I haven't seen anybody else. If Kobe is, I guess, the closest.
Yo, who's better, LeBron or...
Who y'all talking to, man?
Yo, who's better, LeBron or Jordan?
Michael.
And why?
I think, you know, I'm biased, obviously, because I played against Michael. And Michael is just one of those type of players that comes along once in a lifetime. Michael, you could never get to. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mentally, you could never get to him. And believe me, I tried. You know what I mean? I didn't got to a lot of...
Your mama's a bitch.
No, I never said that. No, but no, you just, you know, you could never break his will. You know what I mean? You could never get inside his head. And, you know... With LeBron, I see that a little bit, you know what I mean? You can get inside his head. He's getting better, you know what I mean? Early on, you probably could say that a lot, but you can see as he matured, you know, he's getting better at that. But Michael, you can never break him. And mm-hmm. I think every player that played against him would tell you the same thing. And he made the game look so easy.
Yeah, he did.
Easy, I mean, like uncomplicated, you know what I mean? He didn't have to take the ball between his legs two or three times to get his shot off. He just get to points on the court and he just knocked down shots. You know, he was just one of those clutch. He's probably, to me, I think he's the best clutch player ever.
Word.
You know what I mean? You never see him ever, the majority of the time, miss game-winning shots. When he...
His ability to take over games, his ability to want to have that last shot.
And demoralize you.
Yes.
And scare the living hell out of
yes.
you.
When we think of Michael Jordan, he's just that competitive fire.
I believe that he, every night he stepped on the floor, he put on a cape.
Michael Jordan for me was like, it looked like he was like Jesus, black Jesus walking towards me.
Yeah.
So when he walked in, it was like, I didn't know what to say. It was overwhelming to meet, you know, to finally meet the guy that I've looked up to my whole life.
Gets it to Jordan. Michael challenges and slams.
Yeah, Mike dunked on me, but he knew I was there. That's why he got all hype. He knew I was in there because a couple of games back, you know, we played him and I was blocking his shot.
Jordan, went to the left-hand block by Morning.
He remembered that. So that dunk was big to him anytime he dunked on me, you know, so hey.
Michael Jordan is the best player ever. Kobe Bryant, one of the best
players
ever.
In your last first year, did you play, was Michael in the league your first year?
No, he was coming back to the Wizards. I worked out with him, actually. I do have a lot of stories. I worked out with him for 2 years on his comeback. Yeah, when he came back to the Wizards, worked out every single day.
Charles Barkley is a great, great player, but Michael Jordan is in a class by himself, clearly superior to anybody else in the league.
Have another drink, Bob. I would never say another player is better than me. Never. And I'm not going to say I'm better than him, but I would never say he's better than me. Because I can play basketball with any basketball player in this world. But I would never say another player is better than me because he would have an advantage on me going into the game.
He made me want to be an NBA basketball player. And, you know, just to tell him, you know, thanks for everything he brought to the game and opened the door up for the rest of the players.
Without his vision, I promise you, there wouldn't be no Hall of Fame Allen Iverson standing at this podium if it wasn't for this guy. He gave me the vision, man. And, you know, you want to be fast like Isaiah, and you want to shoot like Bird, you know, rebound like Barkley, pass like Magic, be dominant like Shaq. But, man, I wanted to be like Mike.
You know, we have a chance to play the world champions. And, you know, the day will come where I'll step on the court with, in my eyes, the best basketball player that ever stepped on a basketball court. And it was just an exciting moment for me. And it was something that I treasured for the rest of my life.
Do you feel that Michael is the best ever?
I think so. I think he's the not only the best basketball player, but probably the greatest athlete that's ever played any sport.
And you know, I'm growing up and I'm watching, you know, this guy, Michael Jordan. I think all you guys know him, I think. So I'm growing up watching this guy on TV every day, and I'm like, wow, you know, he's an amazing basketball player. Hopefully someday I get an opportunity to meet him. So I think it was my junior year in high school, I go up to Chicago and I go to a gym called Hoops where he plays basketball in the summertime. And I didn't know he was going to be there. But I seen him walking towards me, and it was kind of like he was walking on air. I had to pinch myself. Is that Michael? Who? And it was like Black Jesus to me. Like, I was like the best, one of the best feelings
I've
ever had.
Now, did he know of you?
Well, yeah, I think he did. He, mm-hmm. you know, he called me a young fella, of course, yeah. You know, and just basically told me to keep working at it and someday I can get to the NBA. I was a junior in high school, so, you know, I guess he told me something right and I just kept working at it.
I tell you, like, when I was in high school, I used to work out with the 76ers, I used to ask him, you know, what's it like to guard Mike? He go, Mike? You mean Black Jesus? I'm like, what the fuck? Black who? Oh, we call him Black Jesus. Or you can call him Black Cat. I'm like, I'm gonna call him fucking Mike. That's his fucking name. So the level of fear that he inspired in others was insane. Wow. And I would tell him, I said, when I face him, we're gonna go at it. He says, oh, you don't wanna do that. I'm like, what? Man, you don't know me, man.
You took Jordan?
I'm never going against Jordan, dog. I've never seen it. I thought Michael Jordan was Jesus Christ. Like, playing to be Michael Jordan. I swear to God, dog. Listen, man.
The first time I played against him, and I walked out on the court, and I looked at him, and for the first time in my life, a human being didn't look real to me. And I'm sitting there, and I'm saying to myself, like, man, that's Mike. And I'm looking at him. I can't stop looking at him. Like, I'm looking at his shoes. And I'm like, man, he got on the Jordans. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, it was Mike. It was my idol. It was my hero. I used to watch him and sit on my mom's dresser. And she used to tell me, boy, if you don't get back from that TV before you go blind, you better. Like, I wanted to be that close to him just watching him.
I'm in his basement, and he have all the old footage on VHS. I'm watching the game. It's like 3 in the morning. He came down there like, oh, come on, we're going upstairs to the gym. He broke down how to score the basketball. That year, I was averaging like almost 30.
He also said that you want to play against Michael Jordan before he retires. He's only got probably 3 or 4 more years left, so.
I know he's an old guy. He's an old guy. But nah, you know, that'd be something that I love to do because, you know, I watched him growing up. I love to play against Magic Johnson, but now he's retired. And Michael Jordan is somebody that I've always looked up to, and I want to play against him.
He's undoubtedly the greatest player in the game. We're going to miss him. And I could tell all my 10 children from 9 different women that I played against the great Michael Jordan.
Are you still close with Michael Jordan, or were you ever close with Michael Jordan?
Michael Jordan and I are friends, and I call him all the time because I like his brand Jordan sneakers and his clothes.
And he sends them to you?
And for free.
Uh-huh. Stockton, inside of Carmelo, they double it. Jordan knocks it away from him. Jordan's got it.
favorite. I don't remember seeing many favorite things in person.
I don't have a favorite Jordan moment, but I have a Jordan moment that I'm like very, very tired of people coming up to me and giving me a hard time about.
There's Jordan for three, yes! Did you see that one, Michael?
Before the game, I was terrified, but to relieve pressure off that, I ain't got a guard for my work. Second thing I said, I can't let him dunk on me. That's not gonna happen. So it was a play when he comes baseline.
Jordan turns and faces. Shot clock at 7, 6, and a
whoa! Shaquille, that might really hit him hard.
I had to touch him up. It was one I'm not getting dunked on because I'll never live that down from family members, homeboys, barbershops. That'll be a poster forever because Mike was the man at the time. But Mike also taught me something very valuable. So when I go to help him up, he said, don't ever help nobody up. Great foul. Don't do that. I don't need your help. But I'm coming back. Don't you worry.
We played in college, and so I used to, like, sometimes before the game, before the night before, we, you know, go eat or go to his hotel room, and he was really mad at Reggie Theus because when he got traded, when Reggie got traded, Michael was the draft pick coming in. And Reggie was like, there's no guy who can replace me that's a rookie. So he said, just tell Reggie that I'm going to get 45 tonight. So I went to the locker room. I said, Reggie, Michael said he's going to get 45. So he ended up with 43. And so he comes into the locker room. He said, I didn't get 45, but you got to come to Chicago. He's like, now that's supreme college.
That's supreme points.
He was mad that he didn't get 45.
I pretty much was watching him instead of just playing against him, you know. I was like, I can't believe I'm on the same court, Michael Jordan, you know, all that stuff. I was looking at the shoes and just looking at him and the ball head and the 23.
I have too many memorable moments about Michael Jordan. None of them are good for me.
I really didn't want to believe a man could actually fly, and he gave everyone that belief that for a little bit, maybe they could.
Whenever I see somebody play guard Mike, I used to always want Mike to take him to the hole and dunk on him.
I didn't know if I was gonna make the league. I was on a non-guaranteed contract. And I'll never forget one of my first exhibition games, we played the Bulls. And I was just trying to make the roster. And Michael Jordan gets the ball right in front of our bench. And I'm already scared to death, like, God, I hope I don't get into this game. I'm not ready for this stuff. And he holds the ball out. He holds the ball out, and he looks right at me. And I'm on the bench, just kind of like, he holds the ball out, and he goes, watch this. And he turns, and he went right around Dan Marley, bam, dunks it, looks back at our bench, and just starts laughing. And I'm looking like, there's no way in hell I can ever make this. Now I really don't want to.
For me, Michael Jordan was, it was a killer. It didn't matter. He wanted to come in and kill you. You know, when I remember my first game playing him in the Spectrum in Philadelphia, he dropped 48 and three quarters and wouldn't sit down and watch the rest of the game.
For the record.
He was playing against the New York Knicks in the playoffs, and I think he must have drove baseline. He faked one way against Charles Oakley, and he spun back the other way, and he drove to the lane and went up for a dunk, and he dunked right over Patrick Ewing, and he stared at him. I think that was one of my most memorable Michael Jordan moments.
Jordan trying to shake off Starks. Oh, what a move by Jordan! It counts, and the foul!
I faced him for the first time at the United Center, and I got thrown into the fire. He made a nice baseline spin move on me. I knew it was coming. He was just so strong. By the time I tried to body him off of me, he just swatted me away like a fly.
I learned a lot this game, a lot about how technically sound Michael was. Because it's one thing in watching him play, and then it's another thing in playing against him. His technique was flawless. I wanted to make sure my technique was just as flawless.
I think we all should be lucky we're even alive to see this guy play. Like, some kids now who are buying his shoes have never seen Michael Jordan play in person. Or they've seen some clips and things like that, but he had no flaws whatsoever. You couldn't say he couldn't dribble, or he couldn't shoot, he couldn't defend.
He didn't have great range. He wasn't a three-ball shooter.
But that goes back, he didn't have to be.
Yeah.
You know, his mid-range was so unbelievable. And getting to the rim, he could finish with either hand. He was so flashy, but he was also so fundamentally sound. You know, so he had everything covered.
Was he mean to you?
No, he wasn't. He actually killed me slowly. And
Yeah, he would comment to the coach, he's actually doing a great job out here. And meanwhile, he's pouring in 45.
Wait, he's talking to your coaches?
Yeah, I remember Chris Ford, he's yelling at me. Chris Ford's yelling the whole time. He's like, rookie, get in front of him, get in front of him. And I'm fronting him on the post, and MJ just kind of slowly kind of glides across the floor, and he gets the ball and shakes and scores. And I did everything the game plan said, and then there's a breaking action. We're sitting there, and you know, Chris Ford is just down there just hammering me, and MJ was like, he's doing a great job, coach. He's actually doing a great job. Meanwhile, he's got 45 on the book.
Being compared to Michael is a great honor, but at the same time, I have to separate that for the simple fact that he's accomplished what he's accomplished through hard work. I understand that. Michael's a great basketball player, but I'm Kobe Bryant.
Getting schooled for a baseline dunk the first time I matched up with him, that was like the coolest thing. It was, because I'd seen that spin move so many times, and then I knew he was going to do it. But the timing on TV and then in person are two completely different things. So he just spun right before I thought he was going to spin, and I was like, damn, that was pretty cool. When I came to the league and matching up against him, what I found is I found that he was extremely open to having a relationship, a mentor relationship. And giving me a great amount of advice and an amazing amount of detail, strategies, workout regimens, and things like that. So, seriously, I mean, I don't think people really understand the amount of impact that he's had on me as a player and as a leader.
My son is easy on me.
He did. He only had 36 points, and they won by 6 in overtime, but you didn't take it easy on him. Do you remember what you did?
I fouled out.
25, 15, 11, and 6 steals.
Oh, wow. None of those steals were against when I was guarding him. we must have been playing on a lower basket for me to score that many points. I remember because I had went to dinner the night before with Michael, and I was just hoping when I left dinner that I didn't upset him. I think he picked up the check, which might have upset him since I was a rookie. But it was just playing against the best, and I got lucky if those were my stats. But we lost, so it's about winning, and that's what he does best.
You know, Michael Jordan for me was always, the person that inspired me the most. And, how he carried himself, how he handled things, and how he carried the athlete. The black athlete, not just in the United States of America, but became a global phenomenon and saying, okay, a black athlete can reach the masses and inspire the masses on a global scale.
My favorite basketball clip in the world, finals, game 6.
5 seconds in regulation.
Michael Jordan sitting on the bench, tired as hell.
Game tied at 86.
And he looks at Steve Kerr and says, they double me all the time, I'm gonna kick it to you.
He comes up, I'll be ready.
And guess what?
It is Michael Jordan time. Scottie Pippen looking for Michael Jordan. Checks the clock. 5 on the cutting board. Here's Jordan. Did not have the shot.
Shoots now the jump shots. He's going to win 5 world championships, and you had players on your team that you could have won more.
I have a friend of mine who I talk to about once a week. You know what he says about Michael's 4 championships?
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't say anything about it.
Because, why?
Because he has 11.
Bill Russell. This is amazing.
And you don't say he's the greatest because he has 11 championships. Casey Jones has 10. I don't think you can predicate how great a guy really is or because he has championships. There's a lot of guys on those championship teams who've done nothing. Michael happens to be, if you want to say Michael's the greatest, I think he deserves all the accolades that you really want. I think the man has done more for basketball than any one individual.
Even you?
Any one individual. And I'm also saying, too, for those players out there today who maybe don't quite respect Michael as they should, almost all of them should be giving about 10% of their salaries to Michael because they, that's who they owe it to, you understand?
And 10% more.
Rep 8, Mike is 4 for 16 from the field. He's having a really rough night.
Right.
So Derek decides, because there's about 10 minutes to go in the game,